आरजे अरविंद, होस्टिंग शार्लेट कर लेना। आई एम हियर विद अ न्यू टॉक शो पॉलिटिक्स एंड नेशन। इन दिस प्रोग्राम वी वुड बी डिस्कसिंग ऑल द पॉलिटिकल इश्यूज एंड द नेशनल इश्यूज दैट हैव इम्पैक्टेड द कंट्री। India is the biggest democracy. General elections are around the corner and the political atmosphere has heated up. And we would like to know what NRIs feel and think about different political issues that are going on. As you know, NRIs always played an important role, be it political or be it any nation building. Even our freedom struggle has roots when Mahatma Gandhi started his struggle in South Africa. Even our current Prime Minister Narendra Modi was very well supported by NRIs. So this program, Politics and Nation, we would like to take up the real issues that are concerning the country. And then we would like to debate not just mere statements, but we would substantiate that with some data, some statistics, and get the opinion of NRIs. So friends, because the issues are national, we want to make it or we want to keep it open to all the NRIs, be it from any state, cutting across language barriers. So that's why I'm doing this program in English. So please join me on Politics and Nation. And today's topic is Sabarimala. But before we dwell into the topic today, I would like to express my deepest condolences and sorrow on the dastardly terror attack that happened in Pulwama on February 14th. I would like to pay homage to the brave soldiers who lost their life. And I would like to, I believe that, like, you know, NRIs are also very much hurt by that incident. And then we would like the government to take action. Mere candlelight vigils will not do. There should be some firm action so that these incidents don't happen, and then no other family should go through this sorrow once again. Having said that, let's move to today's topic, which is Sabarimala. As you all know, Sabarimala is a temple town in Kerala where Lord Ayyappa is a presiding deity. Millions of Ayyappa devotees visit Sabarimala every year. And as with many rituals, many practices that are prevalent in Hindu Dharma, there is a special, there is a difference on this, like, you know, the tradition that Ayyappa temple has. That is, women between ages 10 to 50 are not allowed to enter the sanctorium. So recently, Supreme Court has struck off this restriction, headed by the ex-Chief Justice Sri Deepak Mishra. A 4-1 verdict where Justice Khanvilkar, Justice Nariman, Justice Chandrachud, and Justice Indu Malhotra, they have struck down this restriction and said the temple can be visited even by women between 10 to 50. This caused a lot of turmoil, and we are going to debate this Sabarimala verdict today, whether the Supreme Court decision is right or wrong. If it is right, why is it so? If it is wrong, why is it? Has the Supreme Court taken the sensitivities of the Hindu religion into consideration before giving this verdict? So to discuss all this, I have with me an eminent guest, Sri Kapil Kumar Barabari. Kapil Kumar Barabari is a very young entrepreneur. He has his own IT company, call center. He is an ardent devotee of Ayyappa. And he also is a founder and president of Ayyappa Dharma Sena. Ayyappa Dharma Sena works to preserve and promote Sabarimala and Ayyappa tradition. So please join me to welcome Sri Kapil Kumar Barabari. Hello Kapil, welcome to Telugu NRI Radio.
Hello, hi, Ivan. Thank you very much. Thank you. How are you?
I'm doing fine, Kapil.
Right,
And
thank you.
I, if I'm not wrong, you are on your way to Sabarimala today. So I was
Yeah.
told you are in Trivandrum right now, heading to Sabarimala. Is that right?
Yeah, that's right. Absolutely. I'm on the way to Sabarimala. I go to Sabarimala every month. So from last 4 years, I'm going to Sabarimala every month. So this month, it's my trip to Sabarimala. And you're right. Yeah, I'm at Trivandrum right now. And all my, I mean, I mean, thank you very much for calling me in this program. And I wish you and NRS hello to me from the Telugu NRS from India and from Trivandrum Sabarimala.
Thank you so much, Kapil. So, before actually we go into our discussion on Sabarimala tradition, I just wanted to ask something. You are a young entrepreneur,
Yeah,
okay,
that's
and
right.
then you have your own business, you have own your you have your own call center, and young people like you will be doing parties and other stuff. Like, how come you are involved with something religious like Sabarimala?
It's not about religion. It's basically the importance, the greatness of our tradition and our culture. The one who understands the importance of our Hindu Dharma, Indian traditions, and Indian culture, I'm sure they'll outbeat all whatever you said, the party stuff, or doing all these PUBGs or anything, enjoying going into a different culture. I can beg because the kind of happiness what we have in following the traditions, I'm sure people might think a little crazy, but I can bet you, this is what I keep on telling everybody in my friend circle and in my people who work with me. They keep on asking me the same question you were asking me today. They say, "Sir, how come you go every month? What gives you so much? You go to every month. What is all this about?" I said, "That's all. So greatness about our traditions, which today's generation is missing. So that's the purpose I want to." I want everybody to understand, learn the importance of Hinduism, learn the importance of tradition. And I can guarantee you, Arvind, today that whoever follows Hindu Dharma, whoever follows Hindu culture, I'm telling you, I can bet you, I'm the live example. They are financially strong. They'll be financially strong. They'll be mentally strong. They'll have a great life in the future. I can bet you this. This is the reason, I keep on going to Sabarimala to get more and more, blessings from the Lord and, get more and more prosperity in the life.
Okay, well, I hope people take your word and then start on your path.
Yeah,
But
thanks. Yeah.
our topic of discussion today is the Supreme Court verdict. As you know, on September 28th, a 4-1 bench
Right.
actually turned down the entry of women, like the prevention of entry of women into Sabarimala temple. Okay,
Correct.
and this 4-1 verdict, there is one important observation. The only
Right.
women justice on that bench, Justice Indu Malhotra,
That's right.
she
Yes.
actually did not support this verdict. She was the one who actually went against, and she said that the practice of this prevention of entry or into this temple should continue, because we cannot put our head into a matter of faith.
Right.
So what do you think actually, is this Supreme Court verdict, do you favor that, or are you against it? What do you say on this?
See, before giving my judgment, I would like to make I just like to, make people understand the difference between the traditions. North India and South India are, a big nation. We have different cultures, different religions within the culture, and there are a lot of, languages, traditions here and there. North traditions are entirely different from South Indian traditions, right? If you see, we all know this, South Indian traditions are far more different from North Indian traditions. But when it comes to, Supreme Court, obviously as a nation, there are different types of articles which they bring into picture. As per Article 14 you know, right to equality. You know, this is what, you know, I mean, everybody's talking about. But if you also see Article 25, freedom of religion, that means, you know, specifically, you know, one is not supposed to, you know, is allowed to freely practice his religion. So in the case of Sabarimala, everybody, there is some traditions. We all know about it. Woman is, it's wrong to say that woman is not allowed. Only between the age of 10 to 50 is not allowed. Only because of that puberty period or the menstruational age which they carry. Apart from this, between age 1 to 10, they come, and above 50, they also come. So even they are considered as women. So where is this, the differences between gender equality? There is no difference. If you're completely avoiding women not to enter the temple or, then you can say there is discrimination of women and you're not allowing women. But this is only for specific particular age, and that has a reason, which, we should discuss on this, and there should be lots and lots of discussions should go on. But I purely condemn, whatever the Supreme Court has said. I'll surely they are doing too much intervention into religious practices, which is to one particular community. There are so many issues. If you see, in Muslim community, there is two groups. One is Sunni and Shia. There are, the recent past, there were a couple of years back, government stated to Kerala government, right? There was a burial ground problem. Sunni Shia fought that particular case, and there was a judgment to implement, and Kerala government never implemented this. So there are certain things why you should, you know, target one particular religion or one particular community. So I, as for me, if you're asking me, I condemn, this statement of this judgment. I don't support this.
Okay. So with all due respect to Supreme Court judgment, so you are saying that the judgment doesn't take into consideration
the woman. If you see the woman herself, there is one woman. There should be at least two to three women in the bench, right? There are four men and one woman. And in fact, the one everybody is talking about woman empowerment or woman equality. The woman itself denied it. No, you should respect the practices. So who is asking this? Who actually is asking this? You're fighting for the woman to allow into the temple. The woman itself, the senior, the topmost, judge of our apex court, she herself says you should respect the tradition. So where are we going?
Okay. I get your point. But again, moving forward on the same discussion, we say that, this tradition is prevalent for, many centuries.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Mm-hmm. And then, do really Hindu women want to break this tradition and enter it or enter the temple? Or are these people who filed the case, are these any vested interests who want to create some mischief? Who are these people, who want this, whatever, gender equality?
First of all, this is everybody, we need to understand one simple logic. There is a very big, very big, but it's very simple, which most of us, we are missing. See, if you see Hindu traditions, only in our traditions, our culture, or our religion, you can say, woman is being served as goddesses. If you go to any other community, they're not even being, they don't serve. You go to churches, they're not there. You go to Muslim community, they're not there. Only in Hindu, a woman is being worshipped. That's the importance we Hindus are giving. And if you see who has filed the case in the Supreme Court, it's from some people from a particular community, and they have trying to fight for Hindus, Hindu women, which is absolutely wrong. They just want to divide our community. And coming to what you said, why this restriction, I would like to say, Hindu, in the past, if you see, today we have very big technology, we have a lot of, advanced science, we have great hospitals. If you see, if you just go to, 50 years or 100 years back, a woman used to give, at least conceive 5-10 people easily. And they were the one who used to, maintain or, give a lot of respect to all these traditions, especially in the term of puberty, in terms of this menstruational period. If you see today, there are a lot of people after marriage, they go to, gynecological doctor, and they have a lot of problems in conceiving. Why? only because we aren't, following the traditions. The reason the five, this is something very important I would like to tell you. The 5 days, which is the menstruational time, which happens, most of the women are being given a particular rest. I mean, they're supposed to take rest. The reason why they take rest is because they are the one who are supposed to, who are supposed to be the people who are going to give our next generation. If the woman is not fit, if the woman is not active or healthy, she cannot give a next, generation to us. If our mother was not good, we never had a future. We never had a life. So in our olden traditions, that particular, time, those five particular days, they used to say, the woman has to rest. And in the time being, this has been changed, that it has been considered as, no, it's not rest. They are trying to do some kind of discrimination towards women because they're having menstruational periods. So they think that is wrong. No, that's absolutely wrong. Only in Hindu Dharma, we call woman as Prakruti, nature. Because nature is the only thing which can reproduce. In Hindu Dharma, we say men and, we don't say men and women. We say nature and men. So nature means we're giving such big importance to the nature. So if the nature is not men, not in good condition, we cannot live. We all say we have to protect our nature, we have to protect our nature, we have to protect our nature, we have to protect our trees, forest, everything be safe. But woman is also, so it's
okay.
Protect the woman. So where is the discrimination?
Okay. Point taken, but there is a question, that came during this verdict, that mm-hmm. there was a counter petition filed by the mm-hmm. people who support this tradition.
Right.
They filed a petition saying that Lord Ayyappa also should be treated as a person mm-hmm. and that we should respect his privacy.
Okay.
Where he is actually doing penance on that hill of Sabarimala.
Right.
And then whatever is the restriction, that should continue based on his choice. So,
absolutely.
What do you say about this?
Absolutely. See, here, Ayyappa is an Aistika Brahmacharya. And, he's doing his meditation or penance in Sabarimala. He has chosen this particular place. So, let's say you have purchased a particular place and built a house. So, you set your own restrictions, rules and regulations for your house. Don't you set your own rules and regulations? You set, right? The same way, Lord Ayyappa also has his own rules and regulations. So he has said, because he is being a Naistika Brahmacharya, he said that, we take 41 days of, Vrata Diksha, to go to Sabarimala. If I'm going to Sabarimala, I have to take 41 days of Vrata Diksha and then go to Sabarimala. If I want to climb the holy steps. So Ayyappa also have the same kind of rules and regulations which are said. So we have to follow them. How can we discriminate? We cannot avoid his rules and regulations, right? Because it's his property, because he has set it, his royal family has set it, because he has born in a Pandala Rajam and they have constructed the temple. And we cannot come and say that, we want to rule these traditions. And tomorrow somebody comes and say that, hey, I want to go into the Sanctum Sanctorum and do Aarti myself. I would like to pray myself. I don't need a Tantra. I go to Supreme Court. So do we allow all this?
Okay.
Today somebody says that I want to go. Okay, fine. Tomorrow, the same people will come and say, hey, no, I will go inside the temple. And I'll do Abhishekam myself to Lord Ayyappa. I'll do Aarti myself to Lord Ayyappa. I'll do Puja myself. I don't need a Tantri. So do we accept this as well?
Well, that's a good point, actually. Yeah. So you're saying that the traditions of a particular temple or a place must be respected and
It's faith. It is a tradition. First of all, I would like, whoever is talking about all these things, first, I would like to tell them that please learn the traditions first. First, understand our traditions, then talk about women empowerment or women equality or gender equality. First, understand Hindu traditions. You're not aware of Hinduism, Hindu traditions. You're talking about all these things. So many women have come across. We have seen so many people have come on roads and they said, no, we are ready to wait. There was a big program everywhere. They said, we are ready to wait. Are they not women? Are they not Hindus? Are they not devotees of like Lord Ayyappa? Who all these people have been to Sabarimala, fighting for Sabarimala? No, they are not Lord Ayyappa's devotees at all. None of the Ayyappa devotees said that I'll go to Sabarimala. They all said, we will wait. And that's what, you know, if you see millions of women across, you know, India, across the globe, are supporting Sabarimala cause. And few couple of people are trying to, you know, deviate us only and only because they have hidden political agenda. They want to disturb, you know, our culture, you know, because, and this is the only way to disturb our culture. They cannot beat us financially. They cannot beat us, in terms of army, navy. So they want to beat us sentimentally. They want to beat, you know, or divide us in, you know, using these kind of cheap tactics, you know, hurting our sentiments. That's the only way to, you know, divide us. And that's what they're doing.
Okay, yeah. So you brought up a point that, like, you know, some vested interests are actually doing this. Mm-hmm. So my question is related to the implementation of the verdict. Okay, the right. Kerala government, everybody was saying that it actually went overboard in implementing this verdict. There were a lot of force that was used.
Right.
And then, like, you know, a lot of people, Ayyappa devotees were jailed. Mm-hmm. You go to Sabarimala every month. So you mm-hmm. might be like, you know, like a first-hand witness to all these things. Is this right. all right, what we saw on social media? What did you see, like, you know, during this, like, agitation period, like, when Ayyappa devotees were, like, you know, trying to prevent people from coming there? Like, you know, what is your right. first-hand experience?
Correct. So, see, if you see, Kerala government was saying, the LDF government was saying that, you know, we will make sure we implement whatever the orders have been or judgment has been given by the apex court. All right? This is what we are talking about. So, and they have deployed thousands and thousands and thousands of, you know, police force to make sure that whoever is coming, they should allow those women and go see Lord Ayyappa. Right? So this means they were trying, as per them, they said that they are, you know, interested or they wanted to implement Supreme Court judgment. So I would like to bring a small piece of information which most of the people doesn't know. I don't know whether you know about this or not. There was another judgment by Supreme Court about Kerala itself. There was one particular church called Piravom Church, you know, which is in Kerala. There are two factions in that particular church. One is, you know, a Jacobite, and one is there's another Orthodox faction. So Orthodox faction, you know, faction was not allowed by Jacobite faction. And they have been to Supreme Court and they got a permission, they got a judgment in favor of them saying that they can go and offer prayers. So this means the Supreme, and these guys went to police station and applied for police protection and permission. And Kerala government never gave them, you know, permission or police security. At the same time, and they have deployed thousands and thousands of people in a Hindu temple. So why is the difference? If they want to support or if they want to implement, you know, Supreme Court orders as it is, they should, you know, allow or help these Orthodox faction as well to perform prayers in a particular church, right? Why they did not do? And nobody talks about this. Most of the people doesn't know about this. Everybody is talking about, we want to, you know, Kerala government want to implement Supreme Court's order. No, what about the Supreme Court order in, you know, in Parivom Church? If you can just browse internet, you can ask whoever, all the viewers who are seeing here, ask them to browse internet and see there was an issue. They never brought this up. So they want to divide us. That's what Kerala government is trying to do. They want to break us, and they are trying to do it the best by supporting all these anti, you know, social elements. They themselves are supporting the anti social elements. This is what I personally feel.
Oh, okay. So you're saying the implementation is biased. Okay,
yeah, absolutely.
So before we move to the next question, I would like to just remind our listeners that today, on this Politics and Nation show, we are discussing the Sabarimala verdict. I have with me Kapil Kumar Barabari, who is the founder president of Ayyappa Dharmasena. So I request all the listeners, if you want to share your opinion on this Sabarimala verdict, you can call us. Okay, if you are in US, please call us at 919-701-2005. If you are in India, you can call us at 970-522-2005, and if you're in UK, it's 115-888-2005. Once again, politics and nation, we are discussing Sabarimala verdict. So, NRIs, please call in and give your valuable opinion on the Sabarimala verdict. Okay, Kapil, now we'll move to the next question. So, you said that the implementation of this verdict was biased. The LDF ignored, like, even though it was like a small verdict with like, you know, a few hundred people, they did not enforce the verdict, whereas here they have deployed thousands of people, policemen, and then they are actually forcefully implementing it.
Right. Now, and they,
go ahead.
Yeah, and they themselves are inviting people to, hey, come down, we are here to help you. You know, and Sabarimala is known for secular, you know, fabrication. All different religions, everybody can come in, right? Any particular religion person can come and visit Lord Ayyappa. There is no problem in that. A lot of Muslims, you know, men take Ratadiksha and come to Sabarimala. So they are, you know, giving, you know, they themselves are educating people like, hey, we are here to help you. We are here to, you know, protect you. Please come. Please come. Please come. They themselves did it. Nobody was interested to go there.
Okay. Yeah. I think we saw several messages on social media, like, you know, something of this sort was happening. But do you think what was the right approach? Like, let's say the Supreme Court has already given a verdict. Do you think the government should have consulted all the Dharma Gurus or the temple board or, like, you know, some involved parties and then discussed on how to deal with this, or what do you think was the right way to do this?
Before Supreme Court's verdict, you know, the same Kerala government in the High Court, they said, you know, we will not go against the temple's rules and regulations. They said this, and they get a U-turn. They absolutely get a U-turn. They should have waited. They should have waited till the, you know, Mangala Diksham, the Makara Vilakku and Mangala Diksham. They should have waited, or we have avoided all these tensions, right? There's so many people were so scared. A lot of people, you know, were so afraid, and there was kind of a chaos, you know, that the, every you know, devotee who was supposed to come to, you know, Sabarimala from different parts of the place, you know, maybe from Telangana or Andhra Pradesh, Karnataka, Tamil Nadu, everybody were scared. Because they don't know what was happening. They have no idea, can we go, can we see? And there was issues that, you know, a temple might shut down. So if it was completely chaos. They would have waited. They would have waited till, you know, Makara Sankranti happened. Then they should have, you know, went on and, you know, filed a second petition or calling everybody, call different, you know, Dharma Gurus, different, you know, people, everybody. There are a lot of Dharma Gurus, you know, call the Pandala Rajyam, you know, people of Pandala Rajyam, you know, Tantri, families, everybody, involve all the people, and then discuss and find a solution for this, right? You cannot just say, no, no, we're going to implement this. There is a possibility of putting a, you know, review petition. They did not wait for, you know, putting the review petition. They just wanted to do it immediately. This shows that they are so curious to, you know, get things done and get popular and deviate, basically deviate. Or divert, maybe, you know, I don't know what kind of issues they are doing. I don't know what kind of scams they are doing. I have no idea. But I personally feel trying to do this so hardly, I feel they're trying to hide something else. This is what I can say. I feel personally.
Hello.
Yeah.
Welcome back. Hello. Welcome back to Telugu NRI Radio. You're listening to Politics and Nation. Telugu NRI Radio. This is the heartbeat of Telugu NRIs. Once again, we were discussing Sabarimala verdict, Supreme Court's verdict, which actually removed the ban on entry of women between ages 10 to 50. We were discussing with Kapil Kumar Barabari, who is the founder president of Ayyappa Dharma Sena. Listeners, once again, if you want to give your opinion, please call the numbers 919-701-2005 if you are in US. If you are in India, 970-522-2005. And if you are in UK, it's 115-888-2005. And you can always join us on Skype. The Skype ID is Telugu NRI Radio. So now let's move on to our discussion. So Kapil, you were saying that the left LDF government went overboard and badly implemented this and created chaos.
Right.
So let me come to my other question. There was a lot of talk on the social media. There were a lot of, too many messages on the social media that the Hindu, the women who actually made an attempt to enter, they had a very shady background.
Uh-huh.
Some of them were not even Hindu.
Right.
So is this kind of like a mischief that is being played there, or are they like, you know, genuine devotees? Like, you know, you go there every month. So do you know what is going on? Is the social media right? Or like, you know, and then there was like, you know, very biased coverage. People said that on the media too. So there was only one-sided coverage. So what is your opinion of this?
Okay, that's nice. So, see, if you see, after the Makar Vilakku period, the LDF government said there were nearly 50 women went to see, Lord Ayyappa. And after, when Supreme Court asked them, give me the gigs, they said, give us the names. They said, no, it's only two people, who have entered, Sabarimala. So they have did a U-turn there, number one. Number two, I'm sure, as you said, you're seeing on social media. So there are a lot of videos of two women, in burqas being to Sabarimala. See, normally, if there is a devotee, if you go to any temple, irrespective of gender, if you go to any temple, if you're going to see Lord, you just go stand in front of them, put your hands together, pray Lord, at least for a couple of seconds, at least for 5 seconds, maybe. If it is a big temple, a lot of rush, you can expect that in Sabarimala. So but at least 5-10 seconds you have. You can pray there. If you see that video clearly, I want to ask, I like to ask everybody to see that video once again. They did not see Lord at all. They just entered, they just ran away. They never stood in front of Ayyappa to pray him or take his blessings. So this shows that their motto was only to hurt the sentiments of crores and crores of a Lord Ayyappa devotees. And if you see the two women who have been to Sabarimala, Kanaka Durga, Bindu and Kanaka Durga. Kanaka Durga's, their family, they threw her out of the family. So this shows that they had some vested interest. I don't know what was that. We never know about. We don't know about that. But as far as this all scenario or episode is concerned, it's only an attempt to hurt our sentiments, as simple as that. Because they did not go. They never saw Lord Ayyappa. We all go to temple. We all see Lord for 2-3 minutes or at least for 10 seconds. Everybody accepts this for sure. I'm sure that everybody will agree with me. We at least wait for 5 minutes, five seconds or 10 seconds. We try to pray as much as possible to the God. But they never see God at all. If you see that video following them, the cameraman following them, they just entered it, they took a left and they ran away. That's it. They said, yeah, we've been to Sabarimala. No, they haven't. If they would have been devotees, they would have taken the beatings of the people because they came to see the Lord Ayyappa, right? Why should we be scared of, seeing, when you're so such a big devotee? Nobody's scared, We don't get scared. If you're a devotee, do we get scared of getting hurted? God is there to help us, right? God is there to save us. So why worry?
Okay, so you're saying that they were not genuine devotees, but they were just some mischief makers, which
absolutely
100%. The LDF government was like, just trying to show the world that like they implemented.
Absolutely. Yes.
So you are actually like, an Ayyappa devotee since many years. Mm-hmm. What does like a, and especially you come from Hyderabad, where like, lakhs of people, they take up this Ayyappa Diksha.
Mm-hmm.
What do these like a genuine Ayyappa devotee feel about mm-hmm. what is all going on in Sabarimala?
See, everybody's hurted. When I was out of station that particular time when this incident happened. So I was at the airport when I came to somebody has actually went into. I was so disturbed. Oh my God! I said, I was not having any words. I was disturbed for at least for maybe an hour, then I just realized, but okay, we have to go on. The problem, everybody was breaking. Everybody's so concerned, like, what is happening? And few people also say, like, hey, what's wrong in that? So, again, after a certain time, there was debates going within the Ayyappa circle, like, why not YS, why not YS? Can we go, why can't we go? There are a lot of questions coming up. So, this is where then we decided, hey, it's high time that we should make people realize that what actually are Ayyappa traditions. that's where we come into picture. Ayyappa Dharmasena comes into the picture. So we wanted to make people learn the traditions, why we should wear 41 days of a mala, why should we eat once a day, why should we take bath twice a day before sunrise and after sunset, and why should we do take brahmacharya. So there are lots of questions around all these things. So we have decided to educate people. So what is happening is, as you said, everybody is watching, okay, something happened, and we have no idea, and we have no answer, and we don't know what to say or what to react. So we are completely confused. So we want to educate each and every, citizen across the globe, Hindus especially, that what are traditions. We have taken this goal and making sure that we will teach everybody to understand our traditions and teach them, at least make them, little, as of now, about Sabarimala only, as of now, about only Ayyappa, because as an Ayyappa devotee, I want to make sure that everybody knows about Ayyappa. So I want to make sure that everybody understands that tomorrow, we don't need somebody to, wait. Nobody needs to wait to somebody to come and answer the questions or tackle the situation. If you know all the rules and regulations and traditions properly, you need not to wait. You can dare themselves, that particular point, you can say, hey, this is against my tradition. And this tradition says this. This is the reason we are doing this. And this is no bias. It's being written in the scriptures. It has been written in the Vedas. It has been written in the Puranas. Or it has been, this is why our great saints have, put such kind of a rule. So all these things we want to educate people so that, we avoid this kind of a, situation, and we avoid this kind of a confusion.
Okay. But again, recent news was that the Travancore Devasom board did actually a U-turn.
Right.
During the review petition. So now, where does this leave everything? Like,
absolutely.
Everybody was thinking that they would appeal against the verdict. But now, the board that actually controls the temple itself has taken a U-turn. Where does this leave the Ayyappa devotees?
Absolutely. See, basically, there are two things. One is Pandala Rajyam. One is Travancore board. This is a board, again, it's a political, consists of a couple of political guys.
Kapil, one second. We have a caller. Hello. Hello, welcome to Telugu NRI Radio.
Namaste.
Who is this?
I'm Jayashree.
Hello, Jayashree. Where are you calling from?
I'm calling from New York.
Okay, welcome to Telugu NRI Radio. And Jayashree, I think you are listening to Sabarimala verdict, the discussion on Sabarimala verdict. So
yes,
what do you think? Do you have a question or do you want to give an opinion? What do you think about this verdict?
Yes, I was going to give add a few points to what Kumar Prabhupada was talking about. I am from Kerala, so I just know more. I'm from actually Pathanamthitta district, which is where Sabarimala is. So I feel that we have been, as he said, we have been following this tradition for centuries, and then I know my mother or grandmother, everybody, nobody wanted to go to Sabarimala. We wanted to protect that as such. The another thing that I want to point out is that I heard you asking about the Maishtika Brahmachari of Ayyappa in the temple. Do you have to respect his life? Every deity has a constitutional right. So he's treated as a human being. And whatever the rights that we have, he also has the right. So we have to respect his rights as well. So another point that I want to point out is that we have to separate the religious practices and the constitutional rights, which are two different entities, and they should be treated differently. The last point that I want to add to that is that in Pinara, there was no time for implementation of this court order. Clearly given that in the verdict, it clearly said that it's a public place of worship for Hindus. So if Hindu women are want to or wish to have the darshan of Swami Ayyappa, the government was supposed to give them the security. But the people that have gone, like Rahana Fatima or Mary Sweetie or some Sebastian, all of them are non-Hindus, and the other people were atheists or Mavo or Naxal-related people or communist-related people. So none of these come under the definition of what court has ordered. Lastly, we had a really worst flood that Kerala had ever seen. So every basic facilities, everything was destroyed in Shabarimala and Pampa. Even the bridge was gone. So they could have to ask the requested the court that, you know, we are in a such a bad condition, we cannot even give the basic facilities for the regular devotees who come and visit there. So therefore, we cannot afford to give security or the basic facilities for women. So therefore, we need more time. Community government had flipped the the request to the temple that they to the court that they would keep the verdict, whatever the court, you know, considering the rights of women, like gender equality. I think this is what I wanted to add to whatever that you were discussing on. I hope this was okay.
Thank you so much, Jayashree. That was Jayashree from New York. Thank you for your valuable opinion. So, Jayashree, thank you so much. Thanks for joining our show, Politics and Nation. And we love that, you continue to, join in future and also give your opinion. So, friends.
Absolutely. It was a wonderful that talk show that you are having. Thank you.
Thank you so much. Appreciate it.
Bye.
So, friends, once again, we were discussing Sabarimala verdict. And as we just heard from one of the women devotee, who hails from the same district where Sabarimala is located, she says that the people who entered the temple are vested interests and none of them are actually devotees. So, Kapil, I think that clearly shows that there was some mischief involved in, this whole implementation. So it was not about gender equality or anything.
Absolutely.
So I just want to ask a general question.
Mm-hmm.
Are these whoever activists who are picking on these issues? There are so many other issues that are out there, if you really want to do gender equality, right?
Mm-hmm.
We have seen even women don't get paid as equal if they do the same kind of work. So that there is no gender equality there. There are so many places women are not allowed in other religions where there is no gender equality. And then we have seen that parties or political parties are openly coming against certain Supreme Court verdicts that was to point out exactly that was the triple talaq.
True.
Parties, they are openly advocating that we would abolish triple talaq if we are elected. But on the other side, they are actually working with oppressing the Ayyappa devotees to implement this verdict.
Correct.
What exactly is going on? How do you fight these vested interests? Because it is something which is closer to you, right? As a Ayyappa Dharma Sena, how do you want to fight these vested interests? Because I'm sure they'll be there again in future to do some other mischief. If not this temple, there is some other temple. So what exactly is your plan?
See, basically, what you said is absolutely right. When it was about triple talaq, everybody come out and saying, we have to respect religious, their sentiments, blah, blah, blah. Every particular party said, we'll obviously, if we come to power, we'll abolish that particular thing. So it's they're trying to, appease a particular community. Wherein, if you see here, we're talking about the same sentiments and religion, same traditions, Why don't they support here? Why can't they say, that's okay. If the Supreme Court has given a certain judgment, we go against it. We want the Supreme Court to review this particular judgment and give, let's save traditions. So why different show? It's purely political agenda. That's what I want to make everybody understand. This is not about traditions. This is not about Lord Ayyappa. This is not about devotion towards Lord Ayyappa. This is pure political gain. And all these corrupt governments, I can say, if the current you know, BJP led NDA government is you know, we did not see any scams, or we did not see any kind of you know, issues with saying that, you know, there was some kind of corruption in any central level or higher authorities. There was nothing happening. So they know that if the current government comes back to the power, they will definitely have no life to live. They cannot have a political life. So only because I feel only because of this, all these guys are coming towards one particular platform and trying to, you know, deviate, you know, this culture. They want to separate us in terms of these kind of a small issues, which will really hurt the nation tomorrow. This is not about Lord Ayyappa. And I personally want to say something to you, Arvind, because the entire opposition, I would say political party, was trying to, you know, divide country. I personally feel Ayyappa has involved himself to protect the nation. That's what, because they were trying to distract North from South. So Ayyappa himself involved to make our country united. This is what I can say. And all these other political parties, only and only to save their political careers, they're trying to play with Hindu Dharma and Hindu traditions. If they were so equal, they should have said the same thing in triple talaq as well. They should also come out and say that, hey, why can't there should be a you know, female, a priest in the place of a man bishop in a church. There can be a female maulvi in a mosque. They can go ahead and say that. Why they are not speaking about it? It's pure politics and pure appeasement. Nothing more than that.
Okay, so Ayyappa Dharmasena, like how does it, like, you know, want to fight this? Like, you know, because these organizations who are doing the mischief are well funded and all. So if you don't, like, you know, if you want to stop them, then you have to actually educate people about them and you have to stop their funding. Are you guys doing anything in this regard?
Yes, you know, we do about Ayyappa, you know, when these when the Mandala Diksha is happening, the 41 days, we do a lot of bhajans. We do free of cost, we don't charge anything to anyone. So whenever we go and do bhajans, we try to, you know, promote a little bit about, you know, Ayyappa and his cultures. So we would like to say people, like, what is the importance of, you know, wearing Ayyappa Swami Mala? For example, let's say...
Kapil, let me just interrupt. I think we have another caller. Hello, welcome to Telugu NRI Radio. Who's this?
Yeah, this is Dave Karlikar from Somerset, New Jersey. Namaste.
Hello, Dave. How are you? Welcome to Telugu NRI
Radio. How are you?
Good. So, do you have a question or you want to say something about the Sabarimala verdict?
Thank you so much for sending the invitations, Vilasji and Sabarimala. We are on behalf of the NRI population. We have had various protests in New Jersey, New York, D.C. We have mobilized people. You know, we are strongly believer of the rituals must be respected. These are all Sanatan Dharma, you know, rituals and which have been observed by thousands of years. And it is a woman's right. So, you know, most of our fellow Paginis have chosen that they would like to respect the rituals. And the CPM-led Pinarayi government is basically playing the politics, and their job is to, you know, disrespect our Sanatan Dharma. And they are basically just, you know, planting these so-called people who do not even respect the dharmas, and they are not even Hindu dharmas or Sanatani dharmas, and they are just trying to demolish our belief systems, faith, and then, you know, just make us look bad in front of, you know, the world. There are so many temples where men can't enter. There are so many Ayyappa temples. Only this temple is a Nastika, it's a Brahmachari. The other Ayyappa temples, you know, women from all age groups can go. This is not about women. This is, we are talking about from a certain age to certain age. Women, you know, of that age group, it's been an age-old tradition that the woman choose not to go because it's a, you know, a Brahmacharya Ayyappa deity, and they would like to respect the Lord. So that's what I wanted to say. In the last few years, we have been doing this protest across the U.S. We have mobilized people, the NRI people here as well as in Bharat, and we will continue to do so to fight against these Keralan CPM government as well as the other forces which are trying to demolish our Sanatan Dharma values and rituals. Thank you.
Thank you so much, Mr. Dev. Thank you for your opinion and thank you for sharing the information. So, again, Kapil.
Yep.
Thanks for joining Telugu NRI. So, Mr. Dev, again, as Mr. Dev said, I think even NRIs also are actively working.
Yes.
Like, you know, to promote this tradition. And looks like I personally also have not come across, I've like, you know, checked with, spoke to so many women. I think none of them actually said, like, you know, a word about entering like this temple. All they say is, okay, we want to respect this. Okay,
right.
Do we have another caller here? Oh, 1 second. Who's this?
No, my call dropped, Dev again, so I again rejoined.
Okay, thank you so much, Mr. Dev, for like, you know,
sure,
sharing your opinion and sharing the information about your fight against the Sabarimala, like, you know, preserving the Sabarimala tradition. Thanks for sharing, and do join us every week on Politics and Nation. We value your opinion on Telugu NRI Radio. Thanks. So, Kapil, I think we are almost coming to, like, you know, the end of the show now. So, you have shared a lot of things with us. Okay. So, can you tell us, like, you know, now you are back in India, you are fighting, like, you know, on the Indian turf. You know, how to preserve the Sabarimala tradition. But, like, you know, do you have any appeal to make to the NRIs?
I mean, to be very honest with you, Arvind, when all this thing happened and we were thinking that, because NRI is outside India and they are in the West, so we thought maybe, you know, most of the people may not, they might support, yeah, it's all okay. But to be very honest with you, I should say this, putting hands on my heart, I mean, you guys did an outstanding job. I mean, we never expected that you come out and try to, you know, protect, and say that you have to save our traditions, and you give so much of values to our traditions being there in the other side. So first of all, my salutes to all NRIs out there. I bow my head and say you thank you guys. Thank you very much. Thanks for supporting this cause first. And yes, I would like to say that please do support us as much as possible, because without your support, because what happens here in India, most of the people think that, you know, we are inclined towards West. We feel like gender equality has come from West, basically, because we forget the even most of the women, I personally feel in India, are forgetting that, you know, we have to compete with women, I mean, compete with men. But they're not able to understand one simple logic that women in India is always superior to men. They cannot be equality at all. You're superior. I mean, all women out there are superior to men. We pray our mother, we pray our sisters, we pray our sister-in-laws. We pray them. We treat them as goddesses. So we cannot... You know, a man cannot equal to goddesses. You know, it's human being cannot equal to goddesses. So women are treated as goddesses. So where is this question of discrimination? Where is this question of equality? No, you are superior to us. So please understand this. Do not fall into the trap of all these things. Not fall into trap of all these, you know, companies or marketing companies, you know, trying to say or trying to, you know, deviate us from gender equality. No, that's wrong. There is no, you are superior to us, and you will be superior to us always. And that's for sure. I would like to say this. And we cannot compete with you, to be very honest with you.
I just want to add one more thing here.
Yes,
Dave. Our dharma, and as, again, this is Dave. So in our dharma, that's the only dharma where we have goddesses. We have goddesses Lakshmi, Saraswati.
Right.
If you see all the important, within our prathas, a woman has been highly respected. The goddess for wealth, the god for wealth is a woman.
Right.
The god for Shaurya is a woman, Kali. The god for wisdom, Saraswati, is a woman.
Right.
A man exists because of a woman. It's a 10,000-year-old civilization, which has always been, you know, woman-centered. Woman is always at the helm. None of these other religions, you will ever find a woman to have, you know, they're all male-dominated religions where a woman is always at the second or the third class citizen being treated as. So you know, they should not teach us about equalities and all. Both the genders are unique in its way. And in our civilization, in our culture, we respect them. Even to our Bharat, we call it motherland, meaning it's our mata. So this is just a coined term by these, you know, phobians, basically Christians and Muslims, created to tarnish our Sanatan Dharma. And they just create this kind of ruckus and misinformation. And I respect and I would appreciate that through this medium that we could reach out to our, you know, people across the globe towards educating them. And if they have any doubts, there are so many forums and platforms and associations they could do to. The other thing, Kapilji, we also have a very strong foundation here on behalf of the NRIs. We have Kerala Hindus and many other foundations. So this cause is not limited to only, you know, people from South or people from Kerala. I you know, we had 200 people coming to New York City representing 16 states in Bharat. I myself, I'm a Maharashtrian. Okay, so so I take with proud, you know, I organized that campaign in New York City where more than 200 people came in, you know, all the way from Assam to Uttarakhand, Uttar Pradesh, Madhya Pradesh, Gujarat, Maharashtra. None of these states, basically, if you were to see historically, you know, Ayyappa God, you know, is primarily been more focused and popular in the southern part. But it was our campaign for the last 2 years to educate the masses, because we do not want to have a break, divide and rule kind of a, you know, breakaway India policy, Dravidam and an Aryan and all. So it's all bangas and
bogus. Our
job is to unite Bharat.
People. I just want to interrupt for a second. We have another caller. May I know who's on the line?
My name is Satya Dasapati. I am from New Jersey. I'm one of the organizers who did the rally for Sabarimala in New York City as well as in Washington, D.C.
Hello. Namaste, Satyaji. Welcome to Telugu NRI Radio. Welcome to our program, Politics and Nation. So do you want to say anything? Like, you know, let me come back to you while I finish my talk with Mr. Dev. One second.
Yes.
Mr. Dev, if you want to just, like, you
Satyaji
know.
Satyaji is there. Satyaji is the backbone of our community. One of the most senior, most and deserving selfless karyakartas I've seen. He's a subject matter expert across all our Sanatan Dharma. He has also have the courage to come out of, you know, like many of us are basically sitting in our comfort hole and expecting wonders to happen. Satyaji is one of the few karyakartas I've always seen him, you know, charging in the front and is always there for any cause across all Bharat. So Satyaji is the right person, and I would like him to you know, give his opinion on this cause.
Sure. Thank you for joining us, Mr. Dev. And
sure.
Satyaji, can you quickly, like, you know, say, like, you know, what you wanted to, like, you know, share your opinion, what exactly do you feel about Sabarimala verdict?
Devji, thanks for that introduction. I think nothing is possible unless people like you and others support this movement. What is the recent verdict? I'm sorry, we were so busy with Pulwana and I haven't caught up if there is something that happened in the last 3-4 days. Is there any recent Sabarimala verdict that happened?
No. As of now, there is no.
Just mobilizing, Satyaji, just mobilizing and basically
this,
capturing efforts. They are just brainstorming in. Kapilji is basically doing a lot of work in Bharat. And they would like to hear what, in an overview level, what NRIs are doing towards mobilizing our efforts for the cause, Satyaji.
No, this is a political talk show. This is a political talk show on NRI Radio, where we just wanted to get an opinion of NRIs, what they feel on different issues that are actually impacting India. So as a precursor to that, like, you know, today's discussion was on Sabarimala verdict, and like, you know, I think many of them, like, you know, joined the call and shared their opinion. And Kapil is, like, you know, someone, an ardent devotee who actually goes to Sabarimala every month and then works on promoting the Sabarimala tradition. So if you want to, Satyaji, can you quickly, like, you know, share your opinion so that, like, you know, we can move forward? Our program is almost coming.
Sure. See, I think what we always need to understand is what you see on the surface is only a scratch of the, I mean, a tip of the iceberg. The Sabarimala issue, I think, is one of the agenda of the Break India forces. One of the forces that wants to destroy the Indian culture and take the pieces for them. The one is the Christian missionary agenda. I think for a big part is the design of the Christian missionary agenda. Why is Sabarimala so important for Christian missionaries? Because 60 million devotees go there per year. That is the largest anywhere in the world. Even the, I think the second largest is nowhere close to that. So this many devotees, hardened devotees, if you can turn them around and making the devotees of Jesus is a big, big gain and win for them to put their stamp. And the second thing is the money that goes into this. There is a financial thing that goes around this that we cannot discount, and which is the political parties like leftists, that really matches their ideology. They're anti-Hindu, and the money that comes in, both evangelists. But so if you understand how the missionaries behaved from the beginning, whether it is in South America, Africa, or all over the world, I think it's the Kenyan president, I think, said, when they came, we had land and they had Bible. After they left, we had Bible, they had the land. So that also is happening. But the thing about targeting this Hindu saints, targeting Hindu temples, assassinating Swami Lakshmananda, the guy who assassinated, planned it, is that Nayak, right? Radhakant Nayak, he is the head of the World Vision. And what is World Vision? It's a Christian missionary organization.
Satyaji, let's not digress. Let's limit ourselves to Sabarimala. So we are almost coming to an end of this program. So can you quickly wrap up what you want to say, like, you know, any message?
Yeah. So what I'm saying is the forces behind Sabarimala is a combination of the Christian missionary forces, the leftist forces, and then potentially there is the Islamic forces that they want. It's a mostly Break India forces that want to destroy the Hindu culture, Hinduism as it is, and also destroy India as it is, so that they can take peace parts and use it for their own agenda. That is really what is happening.
Okay.
If you want to summarize.
Yeah, thank you so much for joining this. Like, you know, we are almost coming to an end. Your message is taken. So friends, again, like, you know, there are, like, you know, very... like, you know, strong reactions from, like, you know, NRIs on the Sabarimala verdict. Like, you know, one section, like, you know, some of the NRIs feel that it is a work of some Break India forces, where they wanted to use this as a platform for their agenda. So I think we are almost coming to an end. So I would request, like, you know, the viewers, like, you know, the listeners, that, like, you know, we are almost coming to a close. Thank you, Dev, and thank you, Satya Dosapati, for joining this call and then, like, you know, sharing your opinion. So we welcome you to join our future debates also on various issues. So let's move on. Thank you for joining. And Kapil, I'm almost coming. We are almost coming to an end. So I would like close, like, you know, this program with, like, you know, asking you one final question.
Yes.
Apart from educating, like, you know, people about Sabarimala tradition. How are you fighting the some of the people, like, you know, some of the heads of certain TV channels, like from Hyderabad, they, where you operate, right?
Right.
They are like, they were the ones who were in forefront of, like, you know, who were to, like, you know, make a big splash about this verdict. Are you doing anything on the ground there?
Yes, you know, we are trying to take a lot of legal opinion. See, and basically, we just not want to, you know, make our team divided. So we're trying to take a lot of legal opinions, right? Just to make sure, we want to take proper strict actions with all these anti-national news channels, you know, who are trying to spell, you know, who are trying to divide our society. So we're trying to catch up their past records and what kind of shows they have aired. So we are doing a lot of collection. You know, I am doing it personally myself. We're doing lots and lots of collections from different news channels and what they have done in the past before the verdict or after the verdict, how they're trying to, you know, misrepresent the particular situation, how they're trying to educate, how they're trying to, you know, force people to, you know, do some kind of a things which goes into the law and try to divide that particular organization. So I'm working on this. So probably very soon we'll come up with this, and then we'll put cases in all these, you know, all these TV channels and whoever is trying to do this. Then we will show them in the court of law exactly what they're trying to do with, you know, how they're trying to divide us. We will make sure we'll teach them a lesson, and this will only happen. Only and only will happen with the support of everybody and the blessings of Ayyappa. And I'm sure Lord Ayyappa is with me and with us, and he will make sure these elements who are trying to break our traditions or break our society will never, ever happen. It will not happen at all.
Okay. Thank you so much, Mr. Kapil. Actually, I wish you all the luck on your effort.
Thank you.
And I wish, like, you know, your Ayyappa Dharma Sena keeps doing the work for which it has been formed. Thank you actually for joining us on this program to discuss the Sabarimala verdict. I appreciate your time. I know you are already heading towards Sabarimala. And
yes.
Thank you for taking your valuable time on this.
Thank you. I just, through you, want to just appeal everybody, please. If you want to know anything about Ayyappa, if you want to understand anything about Ayyappa, you can reach our website on www.ayyappasena.com. You can reach our Facebook page, Ayyappa Dharma Sena. We are always here to answer your questions, and we will together fight these anti elements for sure. We will together, by the grace of Lord Ayyappa. Okay, Swami Sharanam.
Thank you so much.
Thank you.
So, friends, we actually are going to close this first edition of, like, you know, Politics and Nation talk show. Well, it was like a very heated discussion. There were few callers who actually shared their opinion, and all of them feel that the tradition must stay. Okay, and the Supreme Court verdict, according to them, did not take into account the sensitivities of, like, you know, the Ayyappa devotees and the Hindu Dharma. So I hope we continue to debate such issues again in our upcoming program. Every week we'll take up one of the issue that has impacted the nation. So I request all the Telugu NRI radio listeners cutting across all the language barriers to get actively involved in our discussions, so that, like, you know, people across the world, like, you know, they know, they understand what NRIs feel about a particular issue. So please keep listening to Telugu NRI radio. Please join me every Saturday 2 to 3 p.m. on Politics and Nation. Once again, thank you so much for joining me. This is RJ Arvind, hosting from Charlotte, North Carolina. Thank you, friends.